In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. All things were made through Him, and without Him nothing was made. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld His glory. Welcome to Living Word Baptist Church, where the Word of God comes alive. Our mission is to exalt the Savior, equip the saint, evangelize the sinner, and empower the community. Our pastor and first lady are Reginald and Vanessa Fletcher. Please enjoy this recording of a portion of one of our Sunday morning services, and stay tuned at the end for general information about our exciting ministry and how you can get involved. Now, let's enter in and be blessed.
For the Lord. Amen. In some way. Amen. Good morning. Welcome to Living Word Baptist Church, where the Word of God comes alive in you. Amen. Come on in. Hey, Miss Rhonda. Come on in.
Good morning.
Our pastor is Reginald B. Fletcher, and y'all know next year we're going on 30 years. Vanessa, 29 years, because 1 year she was just his girlfriend. In the words of Reverend, his boo. Amen. Hey, here at Living Word, our purpose is empowering the community by exalting the Savior, equipping the saints, and evangelizing the sinner. Hey, brother, can you come on the other side here and give me some balance here? You know, always going to have balance. Always going to have balance. Right? We want balance in our life, right? And we know we keep the Lord in our life, right? Even when things are like this, he'll balance it out. Amen. 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 We want to have prayer. Would you stand up? And I told you last week, if you go somebody and hold somebody's hand that you don't normally stand by, don't know, whatever, it makes it easy when we go out in the world and have to pray for somebody. Amen? So you get your practice here, and then you do the application out there. Amen? Come on, Rick.
To God be the glory. We just say thank you, Lord. Thank you for your presence in this place. I feel you. Lord, we say thank you for Sunday school this morning. Even through our trials and tribulations, we thank you for your mercies that they are new every day. We say thank you, my Heavenly Father. And Lord, I just had a flashback. I remember growing up, and it was this toy I used to play with called Weeble Wobbles. It reminds me of the Sunday school lesson, my Heavenly Father. Because you can be pushed, but you was never falling down, my Heavenly Father, because there's something inside of us, my Heavenly Father, called the Holy Spirit, my Heavenly Father. I just want to say thank you, because even though we're being pushed, even though we're going through trials and tribulations, we're not falling down, my Heavenly Father. We just say thank you just for that keeping power right now, my Heavenly Father. Not just for last night's laying down. That was great. Not for your finger of love touching us this morning, but for your awesome mercies, my Heavenly Father. Your grace, my Heavenly Father. An intimate relationship and walk with you, my Heavenly Father. Even though the world looks different, my Heavenly Father, we just thank you that we have you, my Heavenly Father. So no matter what we go through, that we can be a witness, my Heavenly Father. We just say thank you, my Heavenly Father. We don't know who's going through what, who's hurting. But you know all about it. Touch those in the sick and are shedding right now. Those in prison walls and those who are in prison in their mind right now, my Heavenly Father. That you would give them an opportunity to be transformed and be something different, my Heavenly Father. We got to be away, get away from being the church of just coming into a building, my Heavenly Father. We got to focus on, help us to be focused on being transformed, my Heavenly Father. To be something different, to be a child of yours, my Heavenly Father. We just want to say thank you for the opportunity, because somebody didn't get up in their right mind this morning. So we say thank you for blessing us in our right mind, clothed in our right mind this morning. We just say thank you, my Heavenly Father, for all the blessings you give. Thank you for an awesome pastor and a first lady, my Heavenly Father. Thank you for people who just care. Thank you for this assembly, my Heavenly Father, under the sound of my voice. Anybody that's going through something, my Heavenly Father, touch them from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet. We praying for healing power right now, my Heavenly Father. Whether they're going through something in their body, my Heavenly Father. Whether they're going through something financially, my Heavenly Father. Even if they just warm with their spirit right now, my Heavenly Father. Touch them right now with your healing power right now. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Give somebody a hug, amen. Amen. sure you speak to them. We got some guests from Florida in the house, amen. I'm sorry, family. Is it Mumford? Reverend Mumford and Reverend Mumford? Reverend and Reverend? Amen. Amen. Let's go ahead and stand. We're going to do our call to worship again. And it reads, I will bless the Lord at all times.
His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make a boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he heard me, and delivered me from all my fear.
Amen. That's a good God. Make sure we live by that every day, amen. Let's go right into our responsive reading. And it comes from Hebrews and Ephesians, amen. And it reads, remember your leaders who have spoken God's word to you as you carefully observe the outcome of their lives. Imitate their faith. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, tomorrow, and forever.
Don't be led astray by various kinds of strange teachings, for it is good for the heart to be established by grace and not by fools, since those involved in them have not benefited.
And he personally gave some to the apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors and teachers, for the training of the saints in the work of ministry to build up the body of Christ.
Until we all reach unity in faith and in the knowledge of God's Son, growing into a mature man with a stature measured by Christ's fullness.
Then we will no longer be little children, tossed by the waves and blown around by every wind of teaching by human cunning, with cleverness in the techniques of deceit.
But speaking the truth in love, let us grow in every way into him who is the head, Christ.
All together.
Hold your mic up.
Diane's back swipes down, so we want us to if you would, go to the website and use the e-giving app on the website. Amen. Or you can text, and you can give one from your text. Or we still take checks and cash money.
Money orders.
Good morning. We thank God for all of you. A couple of just some things that we want to make you aware of. We have a new calling post apparatus, and it comes up with the Living Word Church number. So don't call the church when you get a call from the church unless you hear a human voice behind you. They call your name. Amen. Normally, we would have the calling post, and you would have a number from Oklahoma. We have a new piece that gives us the ability to send texts as well as phone calls. And then also, we have each of our membership leadership team will get a individual group ID where you can actually send information. So Orlando was wrong. Instead of doing a group text on the phone, you'll be able to do that through our calling tools. And then we'll be able to respond directly to you. And so that way, we won't get everybody's response. Only you will get the response. Amen. Also, we want us to prepare. I want all of us to go to the training on the 9th of November. Will be at Christian Community to give you a taste of what we've experienced when we went to the mountain in North Carolina. And I think that I know that it will be a blessing to you. There are 6 classes going to be offered there. Please, sir, please, ma'am, sign up. We'll have somebody out in the back as you leave on today to sign up. Also, I want to thank everyone that went with us to the revival at Apocena. That was a great opportunity and a great time in the Lord on Thursday. And then most of you that, well, all of you that went received a personal text. From me, so that you can see how the new phone call or post calling post works. So it is a valuable tool you need to really be able to use. Also, we want to just simply remind each and every one of us that ministry is about work. It's not about sitting. So you need to find a place to work in the ministry. Amen. We are looking for workers, ushers, choir members, people on the Seeds of Saints and the Stevens Ministry. One of the things we want to look at doing going forward is to bathe our ministry in prayer.
Amen.
Understand where we're going in terms of what the Lord wants us to do. And so we want to just ask if you would be prepared. Today we're going to do something a little different in worship. Today we're going to have Bible study. Those of you that read the lesson, you know that we've been walking through the book of Ephesians, chapters 1 and 2. We're in chapter 2, we're in verse 4. And so we want to walk through the text. I want to talk to you this morning from the thought, from the subject, but God. So we will lead off and then also give us some direction. But one of the things that is so vitally important, it's not enough to meet us here at worship on the week. You need to take God with you day by day, moment by moment.
Yes.
We can come and be like Pharisees, show up so everybody can see us. But when you go back to your quiet time at home, nobody there but you, you need to understand that God is with you here regardless of where you are and what you're doing. The question that you have to ask yourself on a day-to-day basis is, how true am I to God? And most of us ask the question about God being true to us. How true are we to God? How faithful are we to God? Scripture says God is always faithful. The question is, how faithful are we to Him? He woke me up this morning.
All right.
Started you on your way.
Yes.
Old preacher said, back down south, and said, listen, He touched me with His finger of love. Opened my eyes to the dawning of the new day.
Yes.
This day, the question is, what will you do with it today?
All right.
Amen. I'm not going to go on and on. You know, I've got a few minutes later on. Amen. Come on.
Giving.
Oh, ministry giving. In the book of Malachi, the entire book of Malachi was not about giving funds, but it was about giving lives to Christ. And what the children of Israel did in the book of Malachi was they gave God their second best. Proverbs 3:9 says that we ought to bring the first fruits to the Lord that our vats might be full. Many of us, our vats are empty or lacking because we bring God the second best. Everything else comes before Him. So what we want to challenge you to do is to give unto the Lord, not just of your finances, but of your time and of your talent. Each one of us, God gives us a gift. Use that gift for the edification and glorification of the body of Christ. The book of Malachi, you know, you really quote the scripture all the time. Bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, that there might be meat in my house. Prove me now, even we say, as the Lord of hosts. If I will not open you up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, there shall not be room enough to receive you. But before He gives us the good news, He gives us a warning. He asked us a question. He asked us, will a man rob God? And usually we can talk about somebody else robbing.
Well.
But we have not looked at our own relationship with God. That's really what it's about.
All right.
We don't give to God to get us. We give to God because of the love that He has shown us. Y'all remember what the Bible says? It says that while I was a sinner, He died for me. He didn't wait till I got myself right. He came into the midst of my mess, took me out of my mess, and made me right. So for that, I'm grateful, eternally grateful. And I'm grateful in such a way that it's tangible. It's in my giving. While Paul said it like this, He says, I give as the Lord has blessed me. Many of us, we ask that you tithe. But New Testament giving is to give as the Lord has blessed you. And truly, He has blessed each and every one of us in this place. Amen.
Amen.
Father God, we thank You, we love You, and we adore You. We pray now for the giver. We pray now for the gift. We pray that they might be used for the purpose of building, strengthening Thy kingdom. That men and women might be aware that You are sovereign and that You are in control. We give You thanks, O God, and we give You thanks for these gifts in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Usher.
down.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
It's time for carrying the word, standing on behalf of Archdeacon's ministers. So, this morning I wanted to reach out to you guys and really want you to think about something. We're going into the holiday season. And for most, this is a joyous time. But we've had loss. And there's a lot of people that are hurting during this time of the season. And so for those people who are hurting, we want to reach out and let you know that there is someone here to walk with you so that you are not feeling alone during this time of the year. So for those who don't understand what Stephen's ministry is all about, it's a one-to-one, and as my brother would always say in our meetings, Christian, distinctively Christian, caregiving ministry. So we are 100% confidential. So what you say with us stays with us. So you don't have to worry about somebody else in the church knowing your business. We need you to understand that you are not alone here. There's someone who will walk beside you no matter what it is. So if you need help, please don't hesitate to stop one of us. Reach out to Sister Vanessa. Let us know. And we're letting you know that we are here. And so before I leave today, I had a long talk with my pastor. And he said something that made so much sense. And in hearing what he said to me, I want to end off this morning with prayer for our Stephen's ministry.
Amen.
Bow our heads. Gracious Heavenly Father, we come to you this morning thanking you. Lord, thanking you for what you've done and thanking you for what you will do. Lord, as we stand here before the congregation, Lord, each and every one, you have anointed us to reach out to those who are in need, those who are hurting, those who are in doubt. Lord, letting them know that we are just an extension of your hand. So, Lord, in doing so, we just want to be obedient and we want to serve you the way that you would have us to go. So Lord, I just ask that you place a special blessing upon our ministry, upon our congregation, upon our community. Let everyone know that we are here. You don't have to be and live the word to know the word. To feel the word and to feel your spirit moving through the word. So Lord, we just ask that we continue to do your work in the way that you would have us to do it. And Lord, that you just continue to carry us and keep us and guide us in the way that we should go. And Lord, and that being said, I just want to say thank you.
Thank you, God.
Lord, darling Son, Jesus the Christ. Amen.
Amen.
And now it's altar time. And the prayer ministry is already up here. And you'll still come up and join me.
Amen.
We don't know what you guys are going through out there. Only you know what you're going through out there, and all of us are going through something.
Amen.
We either don't went through it, don't came out of it, but get ready to go back through something again. So whatever that thing is, you have an opportunity now to bring it up here and leave it at the altar while Brother Andre is going to take us to the throne of grace. I'm going to ask the Stephen ministry to go on the outside and let the ones that's coming up for prayer, you guys going to surround them. So my sister here, come on the inside. Sister Rhonda, come on in the inside, and I've been thinking about it. Donna Matthews, I'm going to ask you to come down also, baby girl. Sister Judy, if you can come down and intercede for your mama. Already here. So let's bring our issues down. Come on, Gail. Come on down. Flood the gate. Flood the gate. Flood the gate. Flood the gate. Pastor's going to be coming from Ephesians today, chapter 2. But verse 4 says, but God, who is rich in his mercy, because of his great love that he had for us, even though we were dead in our transgressions. So just because we were dead in our sin, he can change that thing for us. Amen. So Brother Andre is going to take us to the throne of grace. Amen.
Lord, anything that's not pleasing in your eyesight, Lord, I just pray that you would
burn it off of us, Lord. Remove it from our hearts and minds, Lord. Clean us up, Lord. Make us white as snow. But Lord, we're alone in our rooms, Lord. I just pray that we take time to seek your face, to hear a word from you, to feel your touch, Lord. Lord, I just ask that you rekindle that flame that once burned blue with inside, for you. Turn me around, Lord. Have me come running. Strengthen my faith in you, Lord. My trust in you, Lord. Show me how to be the husband, the father, the son, the friend, the disciple. Whatever you want me to be, Lord. Show me. And I humbly accept it, Lord. Lord, I love you and adore you. And these are tears of joy. So I thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen.
Thank you. Alone now, God is still in control now. When you don't know what to do now.
walk with us, that talk with us, shared with us and cared for us.
About what others think of us. Mm-hmm.
than what God has done in us.
All right.
The theme for the book of Ephesians is life in Christ. Mm-hmm. It's not about your good works. It's not about your walking and shouting. It's not even about your singing. It's not even about the proclaiming of the word. You see, many of us are professors of the faith. We profess Christ as our Lord and Savior.
All right.
We tell others about Christ as our Lord and Savior. But the question is, do you possess
Christ?
Oftentimes, you can't tell us from a non-believer. We walk the same. We talk the same. We smell the same. And we taste the same. But there ought to be a difference in who you say we are. So I want to look at text, second chapter of Ephesians. Verse 4. And I'm only going to talk about two words today. Verse 4 reads, but God. What does it mean? But God. What is the significance of him starting this verse with a conjunction? But God. Y'all sit down. Can I walk with this morning?
Walk.
First thing we need to look at is we need to go back to verses 1, 2, and 3.
Yes, sir.
Where it describes the depravity of man. Depravity is a long word that just tells how messy we really are. It talks about how shiftless. It talks about how mean and conniving. It talks about the ugliness of sin that keeps us in bondage. When we believe that we are free, we don't realize that we are in chains of sin. Last week I asked a question, or I made a statement and asked the question at the end. What is life like without God? Many of us are still struggling with our walk with Him. The question that we need to ask ourselves is, what are we investing in Him rather than always looking for Him to give us something? But God. When we look at the text, He opens it up and He shares with us. From the beginning, He says to us that, listen, you who He has quickened. Mm-hmm. Old Testament. Quickened is the word to bring alive or to make alive. As a matter of fact, in the original text, those few verses, that the phrase in there, you have been quickened, was added to the text after they rewrote it in the King James Version. It makes sense, but it was there for a point of clarification. Because we were dead. Why were we dead? Because we were born in sin, shaped in iniquity. You know why we don't come to God today? Because many of us have looked at our station in life, and life and society has excused it away to whereas I'm not as bad as the next
one. All right.
God does not compare us.
Lean not to your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path. Beloved, we are thankful, excited, and humbled that you decided to worship with us today. We pray this recording has been a blessing to you, and that you are not the same person you were before you heard it. If you're interested in worshiping with us again, our normal Sunday morning service times begin with Sunday school for all ages starting at 9 a.m. And our Sunday morning worship and celebration begins at 10:15 a.m. We also have midweek Wednesday Bible study at two convenient times, either 12 noon or 6:30 p.m. For more information about our church and other ministries, please check out our website at www.lwbcindy.org. That's www.lwbcindy.org. Or friend us on Facebook or follow us on Twitter at lwbcindy. Beloved, we just want you to know we love you, and remember, this is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. May God bless you and